guy does a sit out. Sit in principle, okay? He does a sit out, all right? He's in tight right there. Crunch it over the top, all right? I'm gonna jump to the side that I have the trail. From here, I need to just walk him back, all right? Finish. Last one. All right, I know this guy's gonna probably do a stand up. I go to the ankle right away, okay? He still tries to come up, all right? Just like the first one. Crunch him over the top. Jump to that side. Up into his hips.
Turn your feet around.
Okay.
False cradle. False cradle. Hey, let's see who the thinkers are. Why do we call it a false cradle? Why do we call it a false cradle? Anybody else? Not there. Stroke. Because you can miss the leg. The jab. I like these guys. It's not a real cradle. It's not a what type of cradle? You don't have a cross face. You don't have a cross face, right? You just have a cradle. So it's a false cradle. A cross face cradle is a real cradle. You got a false cradle, you don't have a cross face. So here, look at it. Now, here's the difference. I want to teach you the difference. If he has a false cradle, okay, now I have an opportunity, all right, that's why it's not quite as good. I have an opportunity to get my arm up. If I get my arm out, when I can pose, I can kind of put him on his back. That's why we never want to do a roll through. We can't do a roll through with a false cradle. If you have a regular cradle where you have the cross face and you grab your own wrist, you can roll all you want. I don't care. But if you have a false cradle, he can slip his arm out and stop it. That's why we call it false cradle. So